Welcome to another CollectionDX review. This is Yamato's 1/60th scale VF-19 custom Fire Valkyrie. Now, one thing I want to get out of the way first before I go into this review is that I am not going to be covering the more anime accurate little accessories in the video review. You can check it out in the text review at CollectionDX.com. Basically, I just figured that watching me futz around with a bunch of little tiny parts is not very fun. So I'm just going to focus on the main Valkyrie itself. So, as you can see, this thing is cast in a nice, shiny, red plastic, very befitting of the very outrageous Fire Valkyrie, and of course it comes with, I said I wasn't going to futz around with accessories, but this one's essential, is the tiny little Nikki Basara. He's got his guitar, he's got his green tank top that he's always wearing. And it looks very nice. He does kind of fit in there a little loosely, though. And I'm sure people are wondering, well, how does this compare with the YF-19? And see, they're both pretty big, so I'm gonna try to get them in shot here. You can tell they're roughly the same size because they're both 1/60th scale. This guy's a little bit heavier. He's got some diecast to him. And as far as I can tell, they don't share any parts. So, people wondering as how much they were going to reuse from the YF-19 to the VF-19, there is really nothing that is reused. And of course, like all these toys, it does have retractable landing gear, which for once is very easy to pop in and out. Although these doors kind of make a disconcerting snap when you move them. You just kind of fold them down and then you push them in. Alright, so let's start off with the transformation. Now, I gotta say, this thing has a lot of little tabs that hold the wings in place. It's kind of amazing. Like, there's a little tab here that pegs in the tail fin on each side. So what you want to do is just kind of disengage that. We'll bring the tail fins up, but you also want to have enough room to pop the shoulders up out of the legs. And as you can see, it's a very solid toy. Here it goes. And what you want to do next is there's a couple more tabs right over here. Just want to start disengaging the legs. Bring the legs forward. And now there's another tab that holds the whole wing root here in place. It's just right underneath, so you want to just pull the gearwalk joint forward. This joint is very tight. I've heard people actually having trouble with this part. And once you get it done, it comes out nice and tight. You just kind of have to pull on this up a little bit, and then it comes out. There it goes. So we're most of the way through to gearwalk mode. Of course, you want to pull the feet out. And an interesting thing about this is that the feet are actually on ball joints. It's a little die-cast bar in here, and it's a ball joint. You can see it kind of moves all the way around. I guess it does look kind of ugly with it all the way extended, but of course if you want you can just pop it back in so it doesn't stick out as much. Alright, now we want to work on the arms. Okay, just bring these out of the way. The gun pod fall out, of course. And just bring the arms forward. Get that in shot here. the shield pegged on, of course. And one thing about this is it actually has a couple of tabs right in here. They're going to lock in, or a little slot in here, I should say, and a little tab right here, and it helps it lock in at an angle. So it's not quite like the other, the YF-19, where it just kind of sat there in gearwalk mode. Oops. There it goes, that's one tab. And let's get the other one. So there you go. It's nice and locked in place in gearwalk mode. And of course you just want to bring the arms down. There's a little sleeve here that you pull down. Kind of like on the YF-19. Again, bring a little sleeve down. And now you just want to pop this panel open, bring the hands out, and then push back on this. Same thing on the other side. Pull out this, put the hands out, and then retract the forearm. And for the gun pod, it has a little bit of transformation to it. You straighten it out, it's kind of hard to see, but this thing does kind of angle in the back here. And bring the handle all the way forward. And the tab. Tab in the palm goes into the handle, holds it very, very tightly. Oh, and one last thing. And this is very nice. This is one thing I really like about this toy, is that they figured out how to hide the fin, the little antenna, in fighter mode. And what they did is they used a little hatchback here to give it room. And what you do when you want to, oops, bring this fin up is that you just kind of, you just pull it out and bring it up. And it tabs up into the back of the head right here. It's a little loose on mine, but you can see. And here you go, you've got gearwalk mode. It's very nice, very solid. Everything locks in place, it poses pretty well, and it's just very nice. And okay, so we're gonna go into Batarid mode now. And the first thing you wanna do is you wanna, like on the YF-19, you can rotate these canards around. They aren't really held in by anything, so they can fall out, but they just pop right back in. And here, on the leading edge root extension, all you plane buffs know that, you pull this part up on both sides, and one thing you might forget about is that this actually pushes back. I'm gonna show it on the side. It pushes back. So it leaves a little gap right in here. And then you just want to disengage this chest again. Start bringing this pull back section out. And you can bring the head up while you're at it. Mess around with that. And we're just going to leave the back to do what it can do. I'm going to pop down this little plate here. And we're just gonna pop this part. This is actually one of the things about the original YF-19 that was very hard to do, but on here it's very easy. You see it just comes and goes right in here. And one last thing is that we have to bring the nose down. And there's actually a part that, I'm gonna bring the wings around so they get out of the way. Right here, this actually, this whole nose actually goes back on this little black joint here. So it compresses, like, just like that. And do it again. And one more thing is that you actually pull the cockpit, the canopy open, rotate the seat, and then you leave the canopy kind of half closed, and you're just ready to start bringing the rear section up and over. Now, a couple of things are going to line up as this all happens. There's a little indent here for these parts of the canards that stick out. So that's going to line up. And this whole part's going to come down. And you just want to fiddle with this. Make sure it's in place. It's got to be right in the middle. Now this one thing that actually kind of confused me at first was how to get this whole thing to lock down. And what I found out is that you actually have to snap this in place up here first and then bring this whole thing down, and then it starts to work. It's not quite so clear in the instructions at first, but I was able to figure it out. And then you just kind of bring this whole thing down. There's a little tab. Now, let me get this out of the way. There is a little tab in the nose that locks into this plate right here. And you just kind of position these flaps here so it fills in the gap. Straighten the legs out. Collapse them, bring the little cod piece up. And one last thing is that the legs actually swing up on this joint here. They just come out and up. Same thing on this side, comes out and up. And swing the wing back. And here we go, we got the Fire Valkyrie in Bataroid mode. See, it's a pretty beefy looking, actually, considering how sleek the fighter mode is. It's a very nice piece. It's actually very stiff joints. I mean, everything is just, it moves very... Oh, one thing I forgot, and I forgot about this in gearwalk mode, is there's little flaps that come out from the shoulders. Well, there we go. So it looks very, very nice in Bataroid mode. Again, very, very stiff joints. It's heavy, this whole... Well, it's heavier than most of the Yamato Valkyries, because this whole thing in the back here is die-cast. Like, this whole section here is die-cast. So it's definitely got a little more heft to it. Also, these little shoulder swivels here are die-cast. So it's pretty beefy. You can also angle the head antenna out a little bit just so that it gets that anime-accurate look. And of course, I'm sure people are wondering, what does it look like with the YF-19? Well, I've got Mr. Anniversary color YF-19, and you can see, despite the fact that they're the same size in fighter mode, they're a little, this guy's a little bit shorter in Bataroid mode. Now, I have seen you can actually fudge it so that this guy and this guy are the same height. Basically, what you do is you would just, you know, extend the legs a little bit so that you got this big gap here, and then you can extend the feet if you want, and then they are the same height. But, you know, I like to have this nice and compressed so that it looks good. And it does have another nice little feature in this mode. I'm gonna move down, check out the legs here, is that you have hidden missile launchers in these panels here. You see they have the missiles, they're just mounted on little swivel joints. This middle missile is really tough to get out. The top one and the bottom one are very easy to slide in place, but this one is kind of difficult to pull around so that it points forward. So once you do that, you have little missiles sticking out of the leg. Of course, the same thing on the other side. So again, nice features, very complete. Oh, and there's one more feature in battery mode I should get to, is that there is a hatch here, just like in the show. And if you can get your finger in there, you can pull up this little black part, and I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but there's Basara sitting in his seat, ready to get in and out of his Valkyrie. But if I have to say, this is probably one of their best toys that Yamato has put out yet. It's just feels really good. Everything is solid. The colors are basically spot on. It's really amazing. Some of the extra things that it comes with, it's like it comes with a more anime accurate shield for Gearwalk and Battleroid mode. It comes with little panels you can stick in here to just kind of fill in the thighs. But it's not really, you don't need any of that stuff, and that's what I kind of want to emphasize in this review, is that the core toy is very, very good. So this has been Andrew for CollectionDX, and this has been the Fire Valkyrie.